In today's class, we will continue what is knocking. So you see, there are two types of combustion. One is normal combustion, other is abnormal combustion. Two types of combustion. We have two types of combustion. First one is normal combustion. Second one, abnormal combustion. Abnormal combustion. What happens in normal combustion? In normal combustion, the flame generated from the spark plug travels to the end of the cylinder wall smoothly without any disturbance. Let us say, I'm going to draw a normal combustion, a circular, let us say, this is the origin of flame. Point A is the origin of flame. So this flame, which is circular, it is traveling to the end of cylinder. Let us say this is starting point, TDC, it is BDC. When it is going towards bottom dead center, the flame, now this circular portion is known as flame front. It is called flame front. This flame front travels uniformly to the end of the cylinder without any disturbance. Without any disturbance, the flame front travels uniformly. The flame front travels uniformly without any disturbance. Okay. So you see, at the end of the expansion stroke, normal burning of charge takes place. So this figure comes under normal combustion. In normal combustion, the flame generated from the spark plug travels to the end of the cylinder smoothly without any disturbance. In normal combustion, the flame generated from spark plug travels to end of cylinder, smoothly without any disturbance. Smoothly without any disturbance. Okay, please draw this figure. Note down this one. Okay, that is about normal combustion. So in normal combustion, the flame generated from spark plug travels to the end of the cylinder wall smoothly without any disturbance. Under some certain conditions, abnormal combustion takes place. Under some conditions, abnormal combustion takes place, which affects the combustion process, which results in decrease of power output, rough running of engine, damaged engine parts also. That abnormal combustion is of two types. One is detonation or knocking, another is surface ignition. Now, what is detonation or knocking? In abnormal combustion, we have In abnormal combustion, we have first one knocking or detonation. So how it occurs in the inside of the engine? Now the temperature at which the fuel is self-ignited without any external source like spark coming from the spark plug is known as self-ignition temperature. The fuel has self-ignition temperature. It is the temperature at which fuel will be self-ignited without any external source. Like the fuel will be ignited by the spark or by the flame front. These are the means to ignite the fuel. But without the necessity of the spark coming to the spark plug and without the necessity of flame traveling, the fuel will be self-ignited. That is known as self-ignition temperature. Self-ignition temperature is the temperature at which fuel is self-ignited without any external source. This process of ignition is known as auto-ignition. This process of ignition is known as auto-ignition. So what is self-ignition temperature? Temperature at which fuel will be self-ignited without any external source. What is external source? Like spark from spark plug or flame from flame front. After the spark plug burns, the flame forms. That flame formed is known as flame front. That flame front travels in the cylinder from top dead center to bottom dead center to burn the charge completely. So that the temperature at which the fuel will be self-ignited without any external source is known as self-ignition temperature. Okay. So the process of self-ignition of fuel is known as auto-ignition. The process of self-ignition is known as auto-ignition. Next. So in normal combustion, all the charge in the engine cylinder is ignited by flame front only. In normal combustion, all the charge, what is meant by charge? Anyone, please respond. What do you mean by charge? P1C, Boranda Vamsi, what is mean by charge? Vamsi. Rule number 19, what is charge? You can unmute and tell the answer.
Sir.
What is charge? Vamsi? Have you unmuted?
Yes, sir.
Vamsi Poranla, what is charge?
Sir.
Or you can type the message in the chat.
Okay.
What do you mean by charge? No. Charge is not energy. Charge means air fuel mixture. Charge means air plus fuel mixture. Compressed air fuel mixture is known as charge. Okay, in normal combustion, all the charge in the engine cylinder is ignited by flame front. So in normal combustion, this is normal combustion, the entire charge in the fuel is ignited by flame front only. The flame formed because of the spark and the spark plug travels in the cylinder and burns completely. That happens in the normal combustion. Now what happens in abnormal combustion? In abnormal combustion or knock combustion, most of the charge is ignited by flame front, but some amount of charge will auto ignite. So first I will write, in normal combustion all the charge in engine cylinder, all the charge in engine cylinder is ignited by flame front. Okay, all the charge in engine cylinder is ignited by flame front. Okay, but in abnormal combustion or knock combustion, most of the charge is ignited by flame front, but some amount of charge is ignited by auto ignition. What is auto ignition? Auto ignition is the ignition in which the fuel, air fuel mixture, burns without external source like flame front or spark plug. Auto ignition is the burning of the fuel. Auto ignition means burning of charge without help of flame front or spark. Okay, so some amount of charge is ignited by flame front, some amount of charge is ignited by auto ignition, that is known as knocking or detonation. Other term is knocking. Other name for knocking is detonation. It is the process of ignition of the fuel. It is a process of combustion of the air fuel mixture before the flame front reaching the entire part of the combustion chamber. So knocking or detonation is due to auto ignition. Is due to auto ignition of end charge. Is due to auto ignition of end charge. Is due to auto ignition of end charge before flame front reaching the other part of the combustion chamber. Before flame front reaching some amount of charge in the combustion chamber. Okay, next. Now we will see pictorially what is flame effect affecting the let us say this is some amount of charge in the cylinder. Now flame, this is the flame coming from the spark plug point A. Flame is moving inside the cylinder. Generally flame will be in the shape of a circle or a elliptical shape. The flame, the flame comes from coming from the candle, so it will be in the form of a oval shape, elliptical shape or a circle shape. So it is the flame is traveling inside the cylinder. It is moving from top dead center to bottom. This is the traveling of flame front. This is traveling of flame front. This flame, which is from that A, it is moving. It is moving inside the cylinder from top dead center to bottom dead center. Now, this flame front is burning the compressed air fuel mixture. It is burning the compressed air fuel mixture. But at the same time, in the engine, because of the hot cylinder valves, because of the hot piston, because of the hot portion of end exhaust manifold, the fuel air mixture burns. That is known as auto ignition. So this is burning of the air fuel mixture by flame front. This graph is by flame front. Flame front is burning, but at the same time some amount of charge, this amount of charge is burnt due to auto ignition. The charge is burnt by auto ignition. So in knocking the detonation, the flame front is burning the compressed air fuel mixture, and the auto ignition is also burning the charge. Okay. In normal combustion, the flame will travel from A, capital A. Where is the normal combustion? Now I am going to normal combustion again. The flame is traveling from position A to BB dash, and this is the point D. The flame will travel from A to, from capital A to BB dash and to D uniformly. Combustion of end charge from BB dash to D, from BB dash to D, takes place by flame front only in normal combustion. Okay, the flame from A travels towards BB dash. Two things will happen during this process which will create the knocking. End charge between BB dash and D receives heat by flame front, and the end charge is compressed because of the flame front, and auto ignition of the charge, auto ignition charge is also burning the charge, compressed air fuel mixture. So in abnormal combustion, the flame front is traveling from A to BB dash, and this portion is C dash, and this portion is D. So in abnormal combustion, the flame travels from A to BB dash and CC dash, but from D to CC dash, the charge is burnt by auto ignition also. So these two burnings will collide each other, and sometimes forms a big sound. Sometimes from the big sound, which is known as detonation. Okay, so these factors like entrapment between BB and D precipitates slip by flame front, and entrapment is compressed because of flame front. These factors will increase the temperature of end charge and reaches up to self-ignition temperature. Therefore, charge between CC dash and D auto ignites before the flame front is reached. Before the flame front is reached, which is known as knocking. The charge between CC dash and D auto ignites before the flame is reached. This is known as knocking. Due to this knocking, a high pitch metallic sound is heard, is produced. Due to knocking, high pitch metallic, sound is produced. Combustion becomes erratic. Power reduces drastically and whole engine vibrates. Knocking effects. What are the effects of knocking? I will tell you effects of knocking. Now, the salient features of knocking are generally the maximum pressure in normal combustion is approximately 50 bar only. But due to knocking, maximum pressure increases to 150 to 170 bar. Because of abnormal combustion, the maximum pressure reaches to 150 to 170 bars. Okay, next. Only 5% of total charge produces severe knock. 5% of total charge. Charge means, again, I am telling you, it is compressed air fuel mixture which is to be burnt. The air fuel mixture which is going to be burnt is called charge. Only 5% of total charge produces severe knocking. High pitching metallic sound is heard. Inside the engine cylinder, high velocity and pressure waves are produced. High velocity and high pressure waves are produced because of knocking. These are the salient features of knocking. Okay. So if I want to draw a graph, P versus V, PV diagram, if we represent on PV diagram, so this is abnormal combustion. You can see the abnormal A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D shows normal combustion. On PV diagram, A, B, C, D shows normal combustion. A, B dash, E, F. A dash, B dash, E. A dash, B dash, E, F. A dash shows abnormal combustion. So the pressure here is only 50 bar. Here the pressure is 150 bar. In abnormal combustion, The maximum pressure is 150 bar. Okay. Now, what are the effects of knocking? Effects of knocking. Effects of knocking. Please note down these points. Salient features of knocking: maximum pressure in normal combustion is approximately 50 bar, but abnormal combustion maximum pressure 150 to 170 bar. 5% of total charge is produces severe knock. High velocity and pressure waves are produced. And draw the PV graph. Now the meeting may end in 2 minutes. You have to rejoin. What are the effects of knocking? Because of this knocking, the power output of the engine decreases. Decrease in power output. Decrease in power output. Second one, decrease in efficiency. Decrease in efficiency of engine. Why this is happening? Decrease in power output and decrease in efficiency of engine, because more amount of heat is produced inside the engine, which is causing knocking or detonation. So to reduce this heating effect, we have to supply more cooling water. Cooling heat transfer to cooling water increases. Heat transfer to cooling water increases during knocking. Therefore, power output and efficiency of engine decreases because heat transfer to cooling water increases. Therefore, power output and efficiency of engine decreases. Next, third one, because of knocking, another effect is pre-ignition. What is pre-ignition? As I already told you, as rate of heat transfer increases, some parts inside the cylinder, like valves, spark plug, piston, gets overheated. Due to this overheating, hot spot ignition of charge occurs before the spark igniting the charge. This phenomenon is known as pre-ignition, and pre-ignition is very, very dangerous, which will damage the engine. Pre-ignition damages engine, and sometimes blast may also takes place. Pre-ignition occurs due to the overheated engine parts igniting the compressed air fuel mixture. Next, fourth one, mechanical damage to engine parts.